because I need that. Oh, hello! I am the one, the only, I am Hobo Tom. You're watching the Hobo and His Girlfriend Wrestling Show here on YouTube at the Hobo and Girlfriend Wrestling Channel. That almost sounds professional. Wow. I'm sorry, folks. I do have to apologize. I was supposed to do a live stream yesterday. Unfortunately, I got really busy yesterday, and by the time I got home, between just feeling burnt out from working 120-hour work week? Wow. I did work like 120-some-odd hours. Probably a little bit more than that, too. Wow. And so it was that, coupled with driving across the state of Florida, and then coming home, trying to get some more work done, and then having technical difficulties. One wrestling kind of app I use. Yeah, and if you want that app, send this guy an email. And you'll also get a shout out too. Just like these two people. I don't know what this poor person's used to. No World Music actually said I made a great video. I'm capable of making great videos? Someone actually said I have great videos. Wow. Just for that, Normal Music, you get this 6-count. And then also, Kim Namjoon, thank you very much. you are going to get this dirty pin. Again, anyone else out there who would like to get their little shout-out and free video dedication, you can always comment, like, subscribe, or send an email. And I have had people in the past dislike videos and leave their name. They get another picture, especially if you don't say anything at least constructive. Care if you say, what kind of hobo production is that? Oh, wait. This is a hobo production. So again, you can say that. That's a perfectly fair and valid complaint, probably. Like, why are you doing work while you're making a video? All your focus on either your work or your video. Me, I can multitask, though. I'm probably getting fired on Wednesday for multitasking at work. Because, again, I do apologize. I was kind of out of it. By the time I got home, I just wanted to kind of have a couple of drinks and just kind of relax and go to sleep. So I knew I had to go to my other job today. And tell you what, it was one of those days where you have a day like today, you don't want to go back. I don't know. This whole bunch of weird stuff happening over there. We need to find our job. We need to be monetized! Again! Thank you, folks, for all those who have subscribed, watched, viewed. It's going somewhat into my monetization. But the thing I missed yesterday was NXT TakeOver 25. And I have a couple things to say about it. But for the most part, this show kind of snuck up on me. I think it also snuck up on the WWE Universe and the NXT Universe. I'll get into that in a moment. The matches themselves were, for the most part, either good or really good or whoa! This is awesome. Again, when you get to those, I mean, the wrestling matches themselves were pretty good. It just felt like a weird show. I don't know if the production team got there in time or if there were like production issues. It felt like an A-class house show. Which is not necessarily a bad thing, but I think the stadium was poorly lit. It was really dark. I think for the one match, let's say the opening of the Matt Riddle Roderick Strong match, there were like some light issues. It just might have been me. Again, you can always comment and say, yeah, there were some issues. Or like, what are you talking about? Stupid hobo, go back out in the street in the rain and get your cans. Your aluminum. Do that tomorrow, too. I'll have to do that tonight. And then I catch everything tomorrow. Tomorrow's going to be another busy day, because tomorrow, what's left of this actually goes away. That's right, I have that. I was disinvited to work. So, but that's okay. Yeah, I know kind of what I'm doing. That's nice. I think that one project was supposed to wind down this week anyway. So I can live with that. So let's get to some wrestling. This is a hobo production, not a WWE production. It's not a Monday Night Raw production. Whereas the first hour, there's no wrestling. But I talked a little bit about stuff. At least I talked about the wrestling matches as a whole. So let's get to the opening match. We have Matt Riddle. Oh, wait, let's see here. I'll do that. I have to rank myself. I have to rank my guessing ability. Which I think I think I'm in Steph's head. Double team rematch. Shayna Baszler won. And someone else won. Baby! With Matt Riddle, I just kind of reviewed the whole thing because I did watch the little playback. I'll tell you what, the matches themselves were really good. It was fun, enjoyable. It started off really strong. Matt Riddle versus Roderick Strong. Strong did not take too kindly to the flip-flop kick his way. I'll tell you what, the thing I loved about this match, and I'll say this, and I said this, I think, about so many different matches, is the fact that it starts off very technical. It has a very distinct build to the match, but whenever I see a good technical match, a good collegiate style wrestling match in NXT, I'm like, wow, this is great. It's more than two southern guys and malts from bars punching each other. So at least that was the NWA, and probably to some degree Big South Wrestling, AWA, and WCCW. I always get that confused. It's WCW. World Class Championship Wrestling. Unlike the DBBLW, the Daytona Beach Bum Fight League. Which again, I'll have to make another video for that for like a whole month. I have to plan that card out because I'm semi-running out of ideas. Don't worry. Again, if you want, you can always leave a email or comment and say who you'd like to see in the DBBLW face off against each other. But again, more about this. Again, it was very technical based. I go off on tangents all the time. Don't mind me. But very technical. I mean, very catch-as-catch-can match. I mean, there were some amazing spots. Roderick Strong's a master of every type of way to break your spine. I mean, Matt Riddle's great. I mean, there were yay boos. It just had a really... I think the other thing... It felt... And this just might be NXT itself. It was very loose feeling. Very, again, catch-as-catch-can style. It was good. It was enjoyable. It was fun. I mean, Matt Riddle and Roderick Strong seem to be having a good time. The crowd seemed to be loving it. I mean, it's really hard to say anything bad about this match. Other than it just seemed like the main event at a house show. If you go to some house show, some main events are amazing. Some are regrettable, are forgettable. But again, you can see one of my videos about a more forgettable one. But this was actually a really fun match. Therefore, it is a surf and turf quality match. And that leads us really to what I was surprised is the match of the night. And that was the ladder match for the vacated NXT titles. And it featured... So your Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch, team 1-2. The Street Profits, Montez Jordan, and the other guy, something Williams. Was it Montez Williams and something Jordan? I don't know. I always got him confused. I just know collectively they are the Street Profits. Then we have the Forgotten Sons of Cutler and... Who was the other guy? Blake, that's right. And then Jackson Ryker showed up. And then you had... Undisputed Era. And Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly, who right now needs a spinal implant. Because I'll tell you what, this match was utterly amazing. Starts off, the Undisputed Era, they just double-team everyone. They don't care. Which is actually the smart thing to do. And then, it was a fist fight between the Undisputed Era It was a wrestling match that broke down to a fight between Undisputed Era and Oney Lorcan and Danny Burch, which is, you know what, which I'm fine with, because that's the way those two teams should always fight it out. Just be a fight feel between those two. A tag team MMA fight. That's a theory right there, folks. And then all carnage breaks out on the outside of the ring. I have no idea how someone seriously didn't get hurt. Mainly Kyle O'Reilly, because he must have seen the spots that Finn Balor took in his ladder match and said, watch this. I'll tell you what, whenever a ladder was involved, it really seemed like Kyle O'Reilly's back got involved too, which is not necessarily a good thing, nor is it a healthy thing. But those look like flimsy light ladders. They don't look like the good aluminum or fiberglass ones. They look like cheap balsa wood ladders. So I always wonder how much, I know it hurts. I always wonder how much. So what happens, especially when the ladder breaks? Because then you have no idea. Because then it's like, oh, it just shatters. But then sometimes you have no clue what happened, though. Like, if it hurts or if it just, like, shatters or is, like, made out of, like, freaking wood with foam. I don't know. I've climbed ladders, and I know when you get up to the top of them, I think once or twice I have been tempted to do a moonsault off of them or just jump off a ladder. I'll tell you what, when you sit up there, you feel actually fairly comfortable and fairly safe. But that's a whole other thing. I know at one part of the match, like, I love the fact that it's a ladder match that uses ladders just more to get the belt. Like, at one point, everyone's just flinging ladders all over the place. That's why I say, I'm like, these ladders have to be made of, like, balsa wood or something. Because, like, ladders would get not just hurled into people, but just tossed into people. So, I mean, that was pretty amazing what they can do with the ladder. Some of those ladder spots were really creative. I'll tell you what, you could go back to WWE and, oh, whenever the Dudley Boys, the Hardys, Edge and Christian got involved in a ladder match. You thought those were creative use of ladders. I'll tell you what, they were. And only because they started to innovate it. That's nothing compared to this. The back break, the buck on the ladder by Street Profits, that was awesome. I mean, there was an electric chair blockbuster, amazing. Then Ryker Jackson just shows up and just waylays people with ladders. Eventually, everyone else except for the Forgotten Sons, actually just starts to waylay on Jackson Ryder with ladders. This is really cool. I mean, they were just like triple teaming, like, I guess actually six teaming him. And there was a classic 2X ladder spot. Eventually, Montez Ford, I guess, climbed up the ladder for the Street Profits, grabbed both belts. Street Profits win. Again, this, I was watching this match and I'm like, they could do that? Whoa. This is a filet mignon match. I'll tell you what, for the most part, I have some other things, but I'll get to that later. Well, I can get to that between matches. My biggest gripe with NXT takeovers is that they're really short. I think traditionally they've only been like 5 matches long. Granted, they give each match like a good 20 minutes, half an hour. But it's just, again, if I had to pay for this, any substantial amount of money, I mean, if it was like a $40 pay-per-view, I don't even know how much pay-per-views are nowadays. But I mean, I guess you're paying $10 a match. You watch it for free and you're like, and you get spoiled. But I don't know, for 5 matches, I think it only took until from 7 to 10, I think. I know they had the replay start at 12:30, but that's after a whole bunch of stuff. I don't know. I just... Five matches... WWE always has two extremes. Way too many matches. Way too few matches. AEW and Impact have found that happy middle ground between the two where it doesn't feel like too much, but yet you feel like you're getting your money's worth out of it. So again, it's just that kind of weird feeling. So, oh, I have to mention that too. Ooh, first I have to see if I have chops still after my lackluster performance today. I don't know. You guys ever go to work and just not like not feel it that day? Yeah, that was kind of weeks have gone. And today I think it's just a pinnacle of it. Then the next match, it was the Velveteen Dream versus Tyler Breeze. I'll tell you what, it started to be kind of a pose-off, which was fun. It was a really basic match. I'll tell you what, if you just watch WWE and Tyler Breeze and Fandango as the Fashion Police, you'd really never be able to realize how much work he can do and how skilled a person he is. So I was shocked. I mean, if I never saw WWE before, I'm like, that guy's a freaking superstar. He was on WWE and he's treated like a chump. So he's like an unsuperstar. Again, it was a whole bunch of good, it was good wrestling mixed with good character work. At one point, the Velveteen Dream had Tyler Breeze on the outside. He took a selfie picture. Oh, that reminds me. I have to get my... Did I charge it yet? Shoot. I have to go charge my cell phone up. I just realized that. But that... Again, the whole bunch of good... Really, really good character work. From both wrestlers. Tyler Breeze goes up on the top, does his poses. They all do their poses. It was a really fun match. Velveteen Dream won. And then they had that nice, fuzzy, good feel, face moment. They do take a selfie together. And I'll tell you what, it was kind of started off as a basic match. Everyone hit their moves. The wrestling felt right for the most part. I'm getting tired of the leg slaps for kicks, especially when you can tell the guy really misses. There were, I think, a few other botchy spots. It didn't really take away from the match. It didn't really add much to it, though. Yeah, it's really hard to screw up a match of this quality. So therefore, this is a cheeseburger match. Then we get to the women's match, Shayna Baszler versus Io Shirai. And this was a pretty good match. Again, really hard to complain. I didn't realize how stocky Io was. I mean... She's very pretty, very beautiful. I think when you see her in the ring against people of different body types, because Shayna has that kind of skinny fight body. Ember Moon was really stocky and solid looking. Io Shirai is just really stocky looking. You can see a lot in her face a little bit. Very solid. I mean, hey. Io Shirai. Well, I do have a girlfriend. I shouldn't be saying that anymore. Bad hobo. Where's my cat to slap me? She's never around when I... Cat. But I do love my fuzz muffin. Fuzz muffin. Yes. So fuzzy. Anyway, she actually made me happy when I came home because she just wanted to sit on the bench with me and be pat. How can I say no to that? But again, it was pretty good. It started off, Shayna Baszler went over Io Shirai's arms and just kind of really swinging her out. Io Shirai has an amazing moonsault. She did a moonsault from the... But with that being said, though, I mean, Io Shirai, she can do things off the top rope. Those muscle drop kicks were amazing. Eventually, Jasmine Dukes and Maria Sharapova come out. I've seen both their matches. I do need some work and reps. I don't know who would be a good opponent for those two. They came out to distract Io Shirai. Again, distracted wrestlers. Terrible. Candice already comes out with a kendo stick. This is all we're going to say of Candice LeRae? The woman who had probably a 5-star match against the Young Bucks? He's here to, like, be protector role with a kendo stick? Okay. But then again, Io Shirai, again, just like every other wrestler, gets distracted. And that distraction costs her the match, because then she's locked into like the Dan Severn choke. And the difference is the Dan Severn choke is just kind of pulls you back. Whereas the rear naked choke actually like pushes your chin down to your chest with the guy's forearm there. It's hard to describe unless I have a girlfriend doing it to me. Oh wait, that sounded weird. No, I don't like that stuff. Only for wrestling. Wrestle. So Io Shirai taps out. And again, it was a good match. It was a cheeseburger match. And, oh, I have to write that down before I forget. She gets a dirty pin. 6 count. Dirty pin. And then we have the main event of the evening. And coming to the ring first, the challenger from Panama City, Florida, Adam Cole! Bay. Boom! And the champion, Johnny Wrestling, Johnny Gargano from Cleveland! That's how the man with the algorithm says it. Paul Ellering, Cleveland. I'll tell you what, I think I can understand why the crowd was getting a little tired, only because I think that ladder match really sucked the energy of the crowd. They're like, yes, and then it's like that caffeine rush, you're all up here. Over time comes on here. But yes, this was still a really good, fun match. I mean, it seemed everyone was working over everyone's arm, except for Adam Cole, baby. He was working over the knees of said Johnny Wrestling. And again, they had some great spots. They had tandem, they had a stereo super kicks on each other. Again, Adam Cole was going after the knees. Baby! He also busted out the figure. Adam Cole also baby! Also busted figure four. Boom. And then there was the Panama sunrise on the outside of the ring. It's like a jumping. It's like a double jump Canadian destroyer, which is kind of cool. The Panama sunrise. It's really cool looking. Hit that on the outside. I thought that was over. And then, of course, a whole bunch of Gargano escapes. But Adam Cole, baby! Had that scouted. So he would always kind of manage to get out. Again, Gargano always looked like he was on his last breath. Then there was a draping pedigree. Who? Eventually, Adam Cole, baby, did hit the Panama Sunrise and the last shot, the way it should be. And he won the belt. We have a new NXT champion. And with that, the rest of the Undisputed Era were celebratory and came out and celebrated with their leader, Adam Cole, baby. And that was NXT TakeOver 25. Again, my only real complaint, if I could even say I had a complaint about it, is that it just always seems to have so few wrestling matches. And I think for this show, the fact that it seemed really quick, the production value wasn't up to par as really other NXT shows. It was still enjoyable. I mean, if you're going to watch it for free, you might as well watch this. just didn't seem to have that big fight feel to it like other takeovers have had. There, maybe it's because there was no real build to anything. Maybe. Again, overall, I mean, that was an amazing match. So let's see here. So let's go back to my predictions. Yes! Predictions. Let's see. Let's see. So I rightly chose the main event. Had Adam Cole, baby! Winning. So there were only five matches. Shayna Baszler won. 2 out of 5. Well, Street Profits won. That was a goofy pick. Tyler Breeze was not a goofy pick. I was 3 out of 5. Means I'm not so much in the head of Triple H, but I'm definitely inside the head of one Stephanie McMahon. And that was NXT for you, folks. Again, NXT TakeOver 25. It seemed hastily put together. I think the WWE is pushing all their eggs into the Saudi Arabia basket, which I actually should be doing a live stream of this Friday. I think just to prove Noel Music wrong, I think I'm going to do 2 live streams. And I'll set things up somehow. I have to figure out, I have to put the match card together. Should have to do that probably tomorrow. Or tonight. Yeah. And then the Impact I can always do on the fly. So with that, I might probably go to 2 live streaming shows on Friday. It'll be the Super Showdown in Saudi Arabia by WWE. Followed up 10 o'clock at night. Unless there's something wonky happening for a live show of Impact Wrestling, where the volume's always going to be cranked up and you see more images of stuff. Because, well, they let me show more images of stuff. And then, of course, Monday Night Raw, Tuesday SmackDown. And then also on... And then on Sunday-ish, I might also do New Japan Dominion. Depends what time it comes on. And I may or may not lose up. Because I know when I'm doing my grocery shopping at least. But other than that, that was